Good afternoon, traders. It's Bill Baruch with Blue Line Futures, and this is the FX Rundown. The safe haven dollar is on the rise again with emerging market turmoil, everything from Turkey to China. This put the euro at the lowest level since last June when it ripped higher. You have, as well, option sentiment as the most bearish since April of last year. Ultimately, it's starting to show that everybody has started to sell. If everybody sold, who is left to sell? No, the bottom is not a price, it is a process. We're looking at a couple indicators lining up to show major three-star support in the euro at 113.40. Traded again down to 113.27 as a low today before finishing positive on the session at right around 113.70. The dollar index did pair early gains. Watch for this level. Again, 113.40 is major three-star support. You have a trend line going all the way back to 2015 that it broke out above in that June breakout last year, and now that comes in as support at 113.40. So again, watch for this critical level heading into tomorrow. You have weekly jobless claims, as well as Philly Fed manufacturing out of the U.S. The data is quiet out of Europe, but Friday you had the final look of CPI coming out of the Eurozone. Moving on to the yen, the price action of the yen started to stay weak last night as U.S. equity markets finished on session highs. However, support we have in the FX rundown right around 90 in the yen ultimately held, and it sent price action higher as turmoil picked up. That support allowed the yen to move up, and then you had the turmoil again, everything across the emerging markets, and then the U.S. A weakness in the U.S. stock market helped lift that yen. Still, the yen did not close out above resistance around 90.60. We have this on the FX rundown. A close above there, we've had a slight bearish sentiment in the yen, and it's actually paid off selling rallies, but it hasn't closed above 90.68. Look for a close above there. It could start to get legs if it does close above there, but most importantly, it's a safe haven move. If there isn't worries going on, if the equities are not weak, the yen is very unlikely to maintain that rally. So keep a close eye on that. Moving on to the Aussie dollar. The Aussie dollar traded down to 72 on the session, but it recovered back to unchanged. Very surprisingly, with all the emerging market turmoil, that you see that the Aussie dollar not lose further ground. However, it has sold off consistently over the past week and a half to 2 weeks. And there's a point where it just needs to stall and consolidate. We have a rare major four-star level below the market, 71.22 to about 71.5. This is a key level. It aligns multiple technical indicators, and it's going to bring support. Look for a buy opportunity on the oversold Aussie on a test down to there. However, keep an eye, you have employment data coming out of Australia later tonight. It's going to move the market. Lastly, on the Canadian, it stalled holding out above 76.70. A good finish yesterday in the Canadian became a big disappointment today. Crude oil is lower, but you also have a NAFTA deal with Mexico and US. They're very close with this, and supposedly Canada could get left out. Hung out to dry, so we've got to watch for this. It could add further pressure to the Canadian. Give us a call. We're here to talk about anything on the board. 312-278-0500. You can email us info@bluelinefutures.com. You can check our website for updates, and you can sign up for a free trial of our research there. But remember, futures trading involves substantial risk of loss. It's not suitable for all investors. Thank you.